Hello Digmates, and welcome to an Ergobits full of increasingly good news. We've got a new Bazecor release, new firmware to test, new certified refurbished Dygma keyboards, and the biggest news of all, the new Dygma AI.
Hi, how can I help you?
I'm sure you're all wondering what we mean by Dygma AI, but you'll have to watch until the end of the video to find out. First, let me go through the rest of the good news. Let's start with the latest Bazecor release, Bazecor 1.7, which we launched a couple of weeks ago. It includes a nifty little feature I'm sure many of you will appreciate. You can now manually export backups. Go to Preferences, Backups, and press the Export Backup button. You can name and save your current configuration to any folder on your computer. This can be useful before making significant changes to your layout, or if you want to have a layout for Mac and another for Windows that you can easily swap. Remember, Bazecor automatically backups your configuration whenever you save changes. This just makes it easier to save one in particular.
Nice and easy! I like it!
This release also includes some minor bug fixes. We've left a link to the full release notes in the description. New beta firmware. About a month ago, we released the long-awaited 2.0 firmware for the Defy, as well as the 1.2 firmware for the Craze 2, which included rewritten communications between the sights and the neuron for better stability, improved Bluetooth connectivity, improved battery life with the LEDs off, more configuration options for add a key on tap to reduce accidental triggers when using homebrew modifiers, and finally rewritten LED effects for better efficiency. If you want to know all about that release and how to update your keyboard, please check out this video. This new firmware has been a
great success,
but that doesn't mean we have stopped working on the firmware. The team has been focused on one pesky little bug. If the keyboard was wired and you boot your computer, it could accidentally switch to Bluetooth mode, even if your keyboard was a wired-only model. To exit Bluetooth mode and force wired mode, you had to press the top left yellow key. But that could get annoying really fast. This is possible because the Bluetooth antenna is in the wireless neuron, now used for wireless and wired keyboards. If it receives energy from the computer but doesn't detect a USB connection, which happens during boot, it automatically switches to Bluetooth. So, how did we fix this? We developed a state machine, so the neuron knows if one or two sides of the keyboard are connected. Now, if both sides of the keyboard are connected to the neuron, it will never automatically switch to Bluetooth mode. However, you can still access Bluetooth mode if you press the Bluetooth pairing key. If you can't find that key, don't worry. You can assign it with Bazecor in the layout editor under the wireless submenu. This feature can be handy if you want to use the keyboard wired to one computer, to charge it or to benefit from the lower latency, while still being able to switch to your laptop or tablet via Bluetooth. The process is simple. Press the Bluetooth pairing key, and the keyboard will switch to Bluetooth mode. It will automatically connect to the last paired device. To change to another device, press the Bluetooth pairing key again to access Bluetooth pairing mode. To return to wired mode, press the top left yellow key, normally escape, while in Bluetooth pairing mode. If you want to test this new firmware, we've left the links to the instructions on how to flash it in the description. We are delighted with this new state machine. Nonetheless, it has one minor limitation. It needs the size of the keyboard to be turned off for it to work as expected. It won't be able to return to wired mode if they are on. The sides will simply flash red. This is because if the sides of the keyboard are on, the neuron is powered by them. And since it doesn't demand power from the computer, it doesn't get a USB connection either. Please try this out and let us know what you think. If testing goes as expected, we will release this as the Defy 2.1 firmware and the Craze 2 1.2 firmware. Dygma Certified Refurbished. On rare occasions, our keyboards are not a perfect fit for someone, and that breaks our hearts because, after being returned, that keyboard sits in the corner of our warehouse, sad, unloved. Just like me, when you say that you miss Dominique. So we thought, why not find them a new home? That's why we have relaunched our certified refurbished shop, where you can find these keyboards and enjoy the Dygma experience at a discount. Plus, you'll be able to get some of the configurations and color combinations that are no longer available at our normal shop. You can check these keyboards out at dygma.com/refurbished. There are only Dygma Defy keyboards for now, but we'll keep updating the shop frequently, so keep an eye on it. Every Dygma Certified Refurbished is thoroughly inspected, tested, and repackaged to ensure you enjoy the unmatched experience of unboxing a Dygma keyboard. And now, let's talk about the piece de resistance. Je suis, je m'appelle Michael. The new Dygma AI. Okay, maybe we are overselling it.
Maybe a little bit.
But we believe it will be very helpful for many of you. One of our goals for 2025 is to improve our documentation, especially everything regarding guides and troubleshooting. So we've been reorganizing, updating, and upgrading our help center for the past months. If you're curious, you can check it at dygma.com/support. And then we thought, what if we fed all that information to a customized GPT? Could that be able to answer questions and help troubleshoot? Well, at first it was very random. If something was not well documented, it made the answer up, just like ChatGPT. So we spent a few more weeks training it. We tested every question or message we could imagine. And if it failed, we updated our documentation to include that information. It's still not perfect. We like to think it as the Terminator from Terminator 2. Willing to help, but a bit clumsy.
Your foster parents are dead.
But we believe it's now ready for you to test. You can try it at dygma.com/supportbot. We'd love to hear your feedback. So we've prepared a short form for you to share your thoughts or send failed interactions at dygma.com/feedbackAI. We also don't have a name for it. We temporarily named it Dygmai, but that doesn't really roll off the tongue very well if you're not a Spanish speaker. So we are open to suggestions. Please leave yours in the comments below. Of course, this support bot is only additional help. You can always reach us to us at Discord, Reddit, and support@dygma.com. And a human called Anna, Boro, or sometimes Mikel will get back to you. And that's it. As always, remember to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. You don't want to miss future firmware interactions or if our support bot becomes sentient and takes over Dygma. Hasta la vista, baby.